Hi and welcome back to my channel. I'm back with another ampdyno video. Today I have a cheetah amplifier on the bench made by Orion. This one is not easy to find here in Germany. I have the Orion HCCA 250G5 and here are the ratings. The amplifier delivers 50 watts by 2 into a 4 ohm load and 100 watts by 2 into a 2 ohm load, 200 watts by 2 into a 1 ohm load, and 400 watts by 2 into a half ohm. And the fifth generation of these amplifiers is not made in the USA, it's made in Korea. I bought this amplifier defective. I found a bad power supply section, so I changed some FETs and drivers, and I also checked the capacitors. The big capacitors checked very good compared to a new one. So I decided to put them back into the mainboard. These plugs are missing sometimes, and if you have to get new ones, they are very hard to find here in Germany. The amplifier features two fuses, 30 amps each. Here are the RCA input, a gain knob for each channel, a phase switch and bridge mode switch. You have variable low pass filter from 45 to 5 kHz, and there's also a high pass filter variable from 10 Hz to 1 kHz, and a button to change the frequency range from 100 Hz to 10 kHz. There's also Intel EQ that gives you a boost of 10 dB at the crossover frequency and still protects the woofer from over excursion. Let's check out what this amplifier can do on my dyno tests.
I start with 8 ohms mono to test the amplifier into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test, 1 kHz into a 4 ohm load per channel. Straight to clipping, I reduce. Still clipping on the negative waveform. Let's make it clean. Looks good. And it says 50.4 volts of max voltage. The amplifier delivers 81.4 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Let's have a look at the amplifier's efficiency. And the amp pulls 16.17 amps. The amplifier has an efficiency of 69.5%. Continuous power test. 50 Hz input signal, 4 ohms per channel. I got a peak voltage of 49.6 volts. The amplifier delivers 78.8 watts into a 4 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. There's also no dynamic headroom if I drive the amplifier with just one cycle. It's also a little more than 50 volts. So this is for me no dynamic headroom. Now I connected a single 4 ohm resistor to the amplifier bridged mono. That means I'm testing 2 ohms per channel, both channels driven. 1 kHz. Volts. The amplifier delivers 147.7 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Let's have a look how many amps the amplifier pulls out of the power supply. That's 31.1 amps. The Orion has an efficiency of 68.9%. Continuous power test, 2 ohms per channel, 50 Hz input signal. Light clipped. I got a peak voltage of 46.8 volts. With 50 Hz, the amplifier delivers 140.4 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel. Dynamic power test, 1 kHz, 20 cycles. I have all cycles at the same voltage level. Check the last one. It says around 48 volts. This is also no dynamic headroom. Now I connected two 1-ohm resistors to the amplifier bridged mono. That means I have 2 ohms mono connected. That's equal to 1 ohm per channel. Continuous power test, 1 kHz into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. It says 44 volts. The Orion delivers 242 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven into full power. 2 ohms mono, and it pulls 55.1 amps. The amplifier has an efficiency of 63.8%. Continuous power test into a 1 ohm load per channel, this time with a 50 Hz input signal. Volts. The amplifier delivers 216.3 watts into a 1 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Testing dynamic power 1 kHz, 20 cycles. All my cycles are at the same voltage level. I go to the last one. Looks okay. I check the top of the waveform and I got 44 volts. That means there's also no dynamic headroom. I got 242 watts into a 1 ohm load with 20 cycles and dynamic power. And now a single 1 ohm load resistor is connected mono to the amplifier. That means I have 0.5 ohm per channel. Continuous power test, 1 kHz into a 0.5 ohm per channel. Let's calculate with 32 volts. The amplifier delivers 256 watts into a 0.5 ohm per channel, both channels driven. But if I'm correct, the ratings were around 400 watts into a 0.5 ohm. I don't know why the amplifier is doing just 256 watts. Let's have a look at the amplifier's efficiency. It pulls 78.4 amps. In this case, the efficiency goes down to 47.5%. Continuous power test with a 50 Hz input signal into a 0.5 ohm per channel, both channels driven. Doesn't look too good. I can reduce a little more, but I can take the peak voltage. I got 30.4 volts. If I use a 50 Hz input signal, the amplifier delivers 231 watts into a 0.5 ohm per channel, both channels driven. That's far away from the 400 watts I found online on the internet and specifications. Testing for dynamic power, 1 kHz, 20 cycles. All are at the same voltage level. I go to the last one. Looks okay. I try to squeeze out some more, but we get clipping. So I have a peak voltage of 32.8 volts, 269 watts into a 0.5 ohm per channel, both channels driven. I also tested with 8 milliseconds and I got the same output voltage. That means also with 8 cycles, 269 watts. And now output power for just 1 millisecond, 1 kHz, only 1 cycle. And I got a peak voltage of, it says 36 volts. Yes, we can calculate with 36 volts. For just 1 millisecond, the amplifier delivers 324 watts into a 0.5 ohm. So I'm a little disappointed because I checked out the internet for the specifications of a Orion HCCA 250 and I found that it should deliver 400 watts into a 0.5 ohm per channel. So 800 watts bridged mono 1 ohm. I don't get any more output power. I don't know why. If you have an idea, please let me know in the comments. After all these tests, the amplifier is just light warm, I would say around 25 degrees Celsius or something.
Thank you very much for watching and see you next time for another ampdyno video. Bye bye!